All right, well, let's get into how we're imprisoned within progress. As I mentioned, I wrote this back in January 2004, and it was after reading a lot of Gnostic texts and Essenes texts, which I consider myself a pretty decent amateur scholar to look for the ancient texts. I always like to try to find the answers to things, and be honest, I never believe what anybody else tells me. That's why, especially with the internet, I spend a lot of time checking out what anybody says, because even on the internet, which is a little bit more truthful than what you're going to find on mainstream media with the TV and the newspapers that are good for lining your birdcage, you have to check everything out. And part of our being imprisoned within progress is we have all this media trying to tell us this is how it is, and it really isn't that way. If you've listened to previous broadcasts about what I've been speaking of, the Gulf of Mexico and our problem here, then you'll understand exactly what I'm saying. Well, our problem in society, and I'm especially going to talk about North America and even in Europe, we have a problem that we think constantly all the time that we just live in this fantastic, best imaginable world that could ever be. And we base that just on our senses, what we see, what we hear, especially. We base it on that as if that's all there is. So we think that what we're seeing around us, what we're hearing around us, even what we're seeing on the internet, this is it. This is the best there could be. But if that were true, then why does everybody have so many problems? Why are so many people depressed? If this world is the best, why are all these problems existing, especially in the modern industrialized nations that we live in, Europe, North America, Japan, whatever. You know, the problem is let me tell you, this is not the best there is, and the reason that it's not is because we're being blocked in every way imaginable to see what is reality. I was really fortunate in my younger years to be able to go to different countries. And I went to a lot of so-called third world countries. And I say they're so-called because if any listener has ever spent any time in them and had lived there in any so-called third world country, I think you'd realize if you had been there, the simplicity of life. That's an important thing. We don't have a simplistic life in our modern industrialized nations. It's not simplistic. For example, you wake up every day, and the first thing that most people are worried about is, oh, you know, I've got to be at work at so-and-so time. Okay, that's fine. But then when you leave for work and you get in your car, people are automatically thinking, okay, I've got to be careful I don't go 4 or 5 miles an hour over the speed limit, or I'll get a ticket. If I get a ticket, I can't afford it. You get so hung up in the world that you couldn't open your mind or your spirit to anything that came along if it smacked you in the face. And that's the problem. That's why you're imprisoned within progress. Hey, now, going back to third world countries, so-called third world, they're simplistic. I spent a lot of time living in villages in different countries, West Africa. I've spent time in the mountains of different South American countries. The people there are, each tribe or each small community is like a family, one family. There's lots of moms and dads, there's lots of kids, but everybody is part of the family, and that's how they look at things. Now, part of that is because of survival, and the other part is a little bit of tradition. That's the way that it was hundreds of years ago. That's the way it still is with them. But that's not third world. That is a simplistic, open-minded family. That's not what most people in first world countries, I guess, if we're going to put a term on it, people in North America and Europe, we don't think that way. Your neighbor's dog turns around and gets in your yard, and the first thing is you want to go call the animal control or whatever. It's not that way in simpler societies, and our problem is we have to get back to basics. We have to get rid of all this so-called progress. This is supposed to be what we're being told. Oh, this is the best imaginable world. You can have everything you want. Money is how you're going to get there. You get a better job, la-di-da-di-da. And yet that is distracting everybody away from having an openness to see that there is so much more than what this world is. If you're a Christian, I'm sure that you've read at one time or another, and this is a fantastic saying that fits no matter what your religion is, that we're living in the world, but we're not of the world. In and of are two totally different things. Yes, we do live in this world. We do live in this five-sensory world, but we're not of it. So that should tell everybody that this is not the best imaginable world there could ever be. People believe in false appearances. They see fantastic progress everywhere because they're told it's progress. And it doesn't matter what you leave behind. The Gulf of Mexico is one of those examples. This is how the world works. Here we have an absolute ecological disaster, and it really doesn't matter to the world and those who are controlling the world that what they've done is something that's going to affect generations. Okay, that's okay. That's progress. And, according to the world, if you're going to have progress, well, okay, there's going to be a little garbage left behind from time to time. Oh, Love Canal in New York State. Well, yeah, we're sorry we built all those houses on that dump. Okay, well, we'll just, close it all down now. That's not progress, but that's what they call progress. It doesn't matter what's left behind after their progress. This is the world we live in. Sooner or later, man is just going to have a theory for absolutely everything out there. It's all going to be broken down into scientific theories or society theories. And as it is now, the world thinks it can solve every problem. That's not true, but that's what the world thinks because, with technology, we'll find a way. We are bombarded by so much garbage, and now, even more so than 10 years ago, computers, internet, iPads, iPhones, you can be anywhere and you're just connected to everything that the world has. It's just gotten to the point that it's peaking. There's so much garbage out there that nobody has the time to be able to think in simplistic terms, to be able to open themselves to see that there's a whole lot more than what you're being bombarded with. Now, most people know better. They think that they can overcome. Now, religion might have taught them that, whatever. But most people at least have a little spark in there somewhere that, I can overcome all this. I don't have to listen to everything. But the problem is you're hit with so much that you just stay with the illusion.